When we talk about IAS officers, IPS or IFS for that matter, first thing that comes to the mind is how they reach this level. I, Abhishek Mahajan, with my team, is on a special journey today. We'll go to Mussoorie at the Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration, which is also LBSNAA. We'll find out what it takes to be a civil servant. We'll also talk to them and know what rigorous schedule that they follow. Let's start this special segment.
Our journey from Delhi started as early as 7 a.m. We thought reaching Mussoorie will take only 5-6 hours, but no, I was wrong. The roads have been better than before, but the traffic is still a major hindrance in your smooth travel. Good to see the anti-smog towers to cut down on the air pollution. Highway hotels are also taking care of the hand hygiene and government protocols of sanitization. Freshness in the air was apparent as we crossed Rajaji National Park midway, the tiger reserve that encompasses the Shivaliks. Sun was setting fast as we reached Dehradun.
From the busy streets of Delhi and heavy traffic snarls, we are about to reach to the Queen of Hills, Mussoorie, which is 24 kilometers away. And the Academy Labasna is 28 kilometers away from here.
28 kilometers wasn't easy as the terrain was a little bumpy, but we managed quite well to cross that path.
So we have finally reached Mussoorie after almost 8 hours of rigorous journey, but finally we have reached there, and right behind me you can see the front gate of Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration. We'll go inside and see how the academy looks like.
Next day, we got up early in the morning to enjoy the great outdoors. And we all were literally in awe of the surroundings, all set to capture in our cameras the making of civil servants of the country.
The place looks very, very quiet. The place is very, very pristine. And I can actually smell the fresh air here. And rightly, this is called the Queen of the Hills. And talking about the academy, the officer trainees, they have already come in. There are 428 trainees here in the Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration. They have come here for the foundation course.
On the entrance of the academy, Lal Bahadur Shastri's statue caught our eyes. The academy convenes the very best in higher civil service training and capacity building at its sprawling campuses in the salubrious clime of Mussoorie. It is a vibrant campus life, competent faculty, excellent infrastructure for interactive learning to develop professional skills and attitudes which are necessary for a career in public service. India's first Home Minister post-independence, Sardar Vallabhai Patel. His statue is standing firm at the foreground of the academy. We all know the role of the Iron Man who championed the need for a united, all India administrative service.
You will not have a united India if you have not a good all India service which has the independence to speak out its mind. This was said by Sardar Vallabhai Patel on 10th October 1949 in the Constituent Assembly. So this perhaps is the vision and the ethos of this Premier Academy, and since its inception, this academy has been moving on from strength to strength to produce responsible civil servants.
The officer trainees from 20 plus civil services are here to attend the 95th foundation course. 428 probationers are attending a 15-week program. On a typical day, an officer trainee is up by 5:30 a.m. for a PD session, which is the hardest part for any OD. We caught up with the trainees to know their schedule.
So it's just that we have to wake up at 5:30, be there on ground on time, go downhill, then come back uphill and do various type of
exercise. What was your routine before coming here? You used to wake up at 5:30 itself or much later?
Obviously, no. But it was it was around 6:30 or something.
You want to share about the schedule, the training schedule that you follow every day?
Yeah, the training schedule, it's actually a bit...
I know it starts at 5:30 after that.
It's tedious, but it keeps us engaged all the time. In the morning, it's...
5:30, you have to be in the ground.
No, we have to
go by 6:15. So we get up at 5:30, get ready, and once we go there, we'll be half sleep. But yeah. Once our ustad starts the schedule, we'll be all active and awake for the day. So once the PT is done, then we come back, we get ready for the classes. And mostly classes are like interactive. We just don't have to sit and listen. We get a lot of influential speakers who bring in their experiences. They share their experiences. We read about law, public administration and all those stuff. And we obviously have a lot of questions, a lot of doubts in our mind. And after each and every session, we get the opportunity to interact with people whom we thought we have only seen in television and all those things. Now we get to interact them in reality and we clarify a lot of doubts. So all these things in the schedule will help us work better in the ground level. And then post our class session, we have a ECM, which is being designed for extracurricular activities, where we have a mix of opportunities. It can be from wall climbing, horse riding, and you have sign language.
The academy vets theory and practice. After the breakfast, they report for the classroom sessions, which they say are very interactive. This is not an ordinary classroom.
The thrust of this academy is the training imparted to the OTs. There are primarily two big sessions in a day, and the experienced faculty plays a very, very big role in making them and turning them into a bright future of the country.
While coming out of the rigorous classroom and brainstorming session, we caught up with few of the trainees. You came here on 13th, the foundation course started on 13th, and you came here beforehand for the 1 week, and 1 week of isolation was also done.
Yes.
First of all, how do you find the campus?
The campus is beautiful. I mean, the lush green grasslands and like the verdant mountains. I mean, it's an exceptional campus and like I loved being here. Yeah.
Why did you choose to be a bureaucrat? How did that idea come about?
So there are many nuances to this and there are many reasons, but long story short, I would like to say I wanted to contribute more to the public and I wanted more work satisfaction, and that can only happen with public service. So therefore I chose the civil service.
And like she said, that she wants to contribute to the society. What do you want to add anything to it? What's your role? Why did you choose to be a bureaucrat?
For me, why did I choose to be a bureaucrat? The question is simple, but the answer obviously has many layers and nuances to it, as the previous speaker said so. For me, it was just about a process of evolution. I tried a lot of things in life. Some of them worked out, some of them did not.
Like what?
A lot of them. Sports, arts, stand-up comedy, writing on the side, things I can tell, things I cannot tell. And finally, it made sense to me that you know, private sector did not appeal to me in any shape, form or manner. I had my own projects going on, and finally I thought that, you know, I've learned a lot, I've got a lot from society, so it makes sense to, you know, give back, contribute. And so in my position, this seemed the best way to me. And of course, there's a lot of personal growth over here in this environment that we're in.
At the same time, the classes, the pedagogy, it's very, very interesting. So for example, in history, instead of reading the normal textbooks and writing an exam, we are actually thinking of using our extracurricular activities, like presenting the life of the various unsung freedom, unsung heroes of our freedom struggle, using extracurricular activities like maybe a skit, maybe a play or music, filmmaking. So that's also happening. Songs are also there. And at the same time, we're also learning new languages. So I'm learning Punjabi. That's new. That's new for me, and that's very exciting. The faculty is very learned and experienced, and very, very considerate about our needs, and they're really helping us grow as individuals.
According to you, what changes should be made in the country and the state that you'll belong to?
Yeah, like my personal philosophy is like, you know, I have to create something new or unique while I'm in the service. It could be a small project or small micro project that benefits a small farmer, or if it could be a major policy decision that would benefit the entire country. So either ways, I'll be happy if I could be creating something new during my entire service. And when it comes to like changes that we expect to see, we kind of, you know, come up with the diverse backgrounds, and we come up with new fresh ideas as young people. I wish, like, you know, going forward into the service, more and more of these young fresh ideas are incorporated into the policy making. And
do you have a good time to unwind also? You have made friends and you have fun in the mess also?
Oh yes, time can be taken out for everything if one has the desire. So like we get our classes are ended in the evening, right? 5:30 around. So after that, you have all the time in the world to yourself. You can do whatever you wish.
After the session, the officer trainees move for the lunch break. They all have lunch at a huge mess, and we were told that they not only get sumptuous and healthy food here, but much more than just food.
So we are at Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration's mess. And after a hectic session, they all are having a good lunch here. What do you talk about during the lunch? I mean, after hectic sessions, I'm sure you don't want to talk about work.
You have to talk about work. Where is the next class? Which class to be doing? Well, it's very hectic, keep changing here and there. So we talk about that also, and especially that about what we are going to do in night. So night plan can be discussed here.
How about the lunch and dinner, the food that you get here? Good food that you get here in the mess?
The food here is sumptuous. We get a lot of opportunities to taste the cuisines of various regions. For instance, for Ek Bharat, Shesh Bharat, we have the cuisines from across the country. So here we get an opportunity to have a taste of what India eats.
Sumptuous food is saying that you get every day. Are you also happy with the kind of food, different cuisines you get every day?
Yeah, actually our food is being provided by our mess committee only, and the mess committee is composed of our own officer trainees. So whatever we want, they basically provide us.
Officers under training are encouraged to lead a rich, varied and vibrant campus life, extending beyond the confines of lecture halls. At the academy, outdoor events are an integral part of the dynamic training curriculum. Not only this, music, rock climbing and even trekking is also part of the 15-week training that they undergo. As part of the induction level training curriculum, officer trainees are sent on treks in and around Mussoorie and to the greater Himalayas. They learn to cope with conditions of adversity, bad weather, insufficient accommodation and limited access to food. The various clubs and societies in the academy include Adventure Sports, Alumni Association, Computer Society, Film Society, Fine Arts Association, Hobbies Club, House Journal Society, Management Circle, Nature Lovers Club, Officers Club, Officers Mess, Rifle and Archery Club, Society for Contemporary Affairs, Society for Social Service. The officer trainees also like to spend their time studying at the library. The academy boasts one of the finest libraries in the country. Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration houses Gandhi Smriti Library, which caters to the reading, research and reference research of the officer trainees. Gandhi Smriti Library is one of the highlights of this academy. You'll find all kinds of books here, from fiction to literature to history and the rare books which you won't find anywhere else. The library also has the original copy of the Constitution of India. Oath is administered of the Constitution of India to every civil servant once they are done with the training. Meet Dr. Sanjeev Chopra, director of the academy. We talk to him as he essays the importance of the oath.
We are all creatures of the Constitution, number one. Number two, our constitution makes it very clear that the country is governed not by the whims of any individual or the particular belief of a political party or an organization. The country runs on constitutional verities, and our constitution is a great constitution. Our constitution also gives us the protection of 311. Our constitution not only talks about fundamental rights, it also talks about fundamental duties. And therefore, in entirety, there would be few constitutions in the world which will be as inspirational in terms of a document as our constitution is.
The academy also has a mission statement and a song too.
Statement of the academy, you're aware, and the academy song is absolutely fantastic. Rao dharma te dheer, rao karma te veer. So it's a wonderful song and it's a wonderful philosophy.
During special occasions, the academy arranges fancy dinner for the trainees, and lucky us, we were part of one such occasion. But there is more to the life of these officer trainees. We move to the hostels of the trainees, where they sit together after the last supper of the day. On the way to the hostel, we got to see the archives, the old pictures of the academy, and believe me, these pictures touched my heart.
We are at Kaveri Hostel now. This is one of the hostels of the officer trainees. We are standing in front of the rooms of one of the officer trainees, and let's check out what actually they are doing at this point in time. It's 7:40 p.m. before the dinner. Hi guys.
Hello.
So what are you guys up to? I mean, if I come to you first, you guys are having a good time before the dinner?
Yes, a very good time. We had a very long day after rehearsal, after our extracurricular activities, sports and all of that. We've just come, some of us have changed, some of us are still going to get ready, but we're very excited for the dinner now, yes.
Okay. You're saying that you'll have a special breakfast tomorrow?
Yeah. We are going for Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat, no, for Aarambh. So we have this thing planned up, like we'll have special dinner. Today dinner, and then tomorrow breakfast, and then lunch. Okay. And we're gonna have different cuisines of different states of India, representing all of the India. Like this is the idea, Ek Bharat Shrestha.
We have a trainee from Bhutan also. Aap Hindi mein baat karenge? Hindi aati hai?
Hindi thoda thoda aati hai to.
अच्छा एक actually अब मैंने सुना है कि आप बहुत अच्छा गाना गाते हो, अच्छा सा गाना सुना दीजिए.
I'm sorry, I can't sing.
रोक के ज़माना चाहे टोके खुदाई, तुमको आना पड़ेगा, जो वादा किया वो निभाना पड़ेगा, निभाना पड़ेगा.
माना मदरम हमर किलेले पच किलेयुंड केटद केटद केल्वी என்ன, உன் கண்ணு ரொம்ப அழகா, இறக்கு ரொம்ப அழகா, இந்த கேள்வி என்னை கேட்க என்ன நான் பாடுவேன். மதுர மம்மர கிளையிலே பச்சக்கிளியன்னு கேட்டது கேட்டது கேள்வி என்ன, என் கண்ணு ரொம்ப அழகா, என் ரொக்க ரொம்ப அழகா, இந்த கேள்வி என கேட்க என்ன நான் பாடுவேன்.
मैं अपना लैपटॉप ऑन करता हूँ, लाउड स्पीकर पे गाने बजाता हूँ और पूरे फ्लोर को ऐसा. तो हाँ, नहीं एक्चुअली एवरीवन हैज सेड द राइट थिंग कि इट इज नॉट दैट देयर इज अ स्ट्रेसफुल एनवायरनमेंट. फ्रॉम द मॉर्निंग वी गेट अप टू द नाइट, एवरीथिंग इज एज एंजॉयमेंट एज इट्स द फर्स्ट डे वी वर हियर. सो इट्स नेवर लाइक वी आर नॉट गेटिंग स्ट्रेस्ड. तो इट्स वेरी फन. दिस इज exactly what happens.
I get up at 5:30 and I wake up. Yeah, so I get up, I get ready.
5:30 you have to reach there, no, on the ground.
No, by 6:30.
Okay.
So I go to every room, I knock their room. So if they are not awake, I go bang their door and make them get ready, and then we all go together to the ground. And it's really fun.
But wonder what these trainees do when they are bored of the mess meal or to smash the hunger pangs. This is the place where most of them will be found. This is the famous Ganga Dhaba, which is adjacent to the Ganga Hostel. The Dhaba, which was a tea shop earlier, is 90 years old.
ये 90 साल पुराना ढाबा है और सारे ट्रेनीज यहाँ पर नाश्ता खाना खाने आते हैं.
हाँ जी बिल्कुल.
तो ये 90 साल पुराना ये ढाबा है, क्या क्या यहाँ पर?
ढाबा तो अभी एक करीब 30-35 साल पुराना है. उससे पहले हमारी टी शॉप होती थी और उसके बाद फिर हमने इसे ढाबे को शुरू किया.
ट्रेनी सबसे ज्यादा यहाँ पर क्या पसंद करते हैं खाने?
परांठे हैं, मोमोज हैं. तो नॉन वेज तो हम नहीं बनाते हैं, वेज मोमोज बनाते हैं, वो बहुत पसंद करते हैं. परांठा हमारे बहुत पसंद करते हैं. बाकी तो हम लोग बहुत चीज़ें बनाते हैं, स्नैक्स वगैरह बहुत सारी चीज़ें बनाते हैं, लेकिन ज़्यादातर ये पसंद बहुत करते हैं.
इट्स अ वेरी वेरी ओल्ड ढाबा एंड यू कम हियर डेली टू हैव फूड?
नो, they also provide home delivery, hostel delivery, so we order something when we are, you know, having those hunger pangs.
When you are bored of having mess food, then you come here?
Yes, sure, because and it offers us food round the clock. So anytime we feel hungry, even after our PT, we can come here.
What is the tastiest dish that they give you?
I have one Maggi favorite, so like veg Maggi and cheese Maggi I like.
These trainees are the future of India and ready to don the gloves of a civil servant. And not to forget, among the academy's distinguished alumni are vice presidents, cabinet ministers, governors, heads of the civil services at the union and the states, ambassadors, police chiefs, environment and forest conservationists, and others who, without much public visibility, are engaged in the task of delivering the vision of an inclusive and developed India with commitment and dedication. The Academy is committed to building an effective, efficient, responsive, and accountable civil service characterized by integrity in both thought and action.
The mindset of these officers look completely different, and they look all set to be the future of India and ready to don the gloves of a civil servant. And hats off to the academy also, the way they train their officers, and the location also looks very beautiful. That's all we have in this segment. I, Abhishek Mahajan, signing off with cameraman Kumar Datta and lighting assistant Rajkumar. Take care. Stay safe.